I brought you here because you have been bestowed an incredible honor. The Order of Ontario is recognizing the great work that you've done for the community, for areas that were kind of dilapidated and kind of left behind, because it's easy to do that. You know that. It's easy to pick a room in the house that you don't necessarily like and abandon it, but sooner or later, if you don't pay attention to it, it'll kill the rest of the fucking house.
Absolutely. Well, from what I understand, it's the highest award, honor you can achieve in Ontario for working with various causes that are benevolent. But, you know, I'm humbled by it. I didn't see it coming, but I appreciate it. But you know what, Frank? Somebody got to step up to the plate.
And Giorgio, saw that in you, and he helped you start your dream.
Many years ago, actually, when I opened the Spider's Web Youth Empowerment Center, George suggested I go to a couple of corporate people in the area, and he set things up.
To create an alliance?
Absolutely, and I got my first large contribution, so that I could hire the right kind of staff to work with these underprivileged children, these youth at risk. And I've never stopped thanking George. We go back a long way. We don't always agree with the same politics, but we have a lot in common.
It doesn't matter.
We've been friends for years.
It doesn't matter. It's what your soul's about that matters, and your soul has always been with the at risk.
Well, he's a good soul. There's two types of people in the world. There's assholes and good souls.
Yeah, well, I'm both.
Spider's a good.
But I'm both.
Well, George has got more.
Actually, George, I've heard nothing but good things about you. And I think that sometimes when you try to do good.
Yeah, but sometimes you have to be an asshole to be good.
I don't necessarily believe.
You can't take the people that want to throw it at you and just accept what they want to throw at you. You've got to fight back.
When Spider Jones was introduced to you, what made you, like, you know, in the position you were very busy, you get a lot of people who want handouts, or a lot of people who need help, so you have to prioritize to see what is the most important. But what captured you?
Two things. First, he had his heart in the right place, and you see it with him. If you get to know this gentleman like I have, you'll know exactly what's in his heart and his soul, and he really means what he says about at-risk youth. He's not after money, which to me makes a big difference. He's after making someone's life turn around like his has, and he wants to be a mentor, and he is, and I can speak for that. I know that he is, because he's got so many kids that adore him. But secondly, he's not after government money, and that for me made a big difference. He wanted to do it without the government's money. He wanted to do it with the private sector. He wanted to do it with sponsorship of other people that might want to care, corporate companies that want to give back. And for me, those are the two reasons that I supported Spider from the get-go.
Well, it's great, and it's awesome to see the relationship and respect you both have for each other.
Yeah, George and I go way back. We've had a lot of good times together. He dropped by the center. I remember in my opening day, he was there. But George would come by and just work with the kids and get to know them, you know. And it's nice that somebody that was a politician, somebody in office, would take the time out of their schedule to come by and visit the kids. And the fact is this, let's face it, you had a lot of corporate contacts, and you helped me with them.
One of the things, Spider, that you may want to talk about
we do this.
Can't touch
time.
Anymore. Yeah, curl your body after somebody.
Listen, coronavirus, you know.
What does the Order of Ontario mean to you at this stage of your life? Because you look great, and a lot of people do know this. You're a great singer. You're a great R&B singer. We've had you sing on the show with us. You've been on the Being Frank show 6-7 times.
Absolutely.
But music is part of your passion. Is what you?
It's my opium. Music's my. Yeah. I call it my opium. Music is when I want to get high or just chill out and relax. Yeah. You know, it's a natural high just listening to. But not just R&B. But I can get off on some old school. You know, country and western, or the Eagles, Marty Robbins. I can get
great
off
music.
On. Yeah, I love it.
You like music that has a melody, you have a music that's poetic.
Yeah.
So what does the Order of Ontario mean to you? That is an incredible honor. Not a lot of people get it. Only very few people open that door of greatness. And for you to have this bestowed on you, what does it mean to you at this stage of your life?
It means a lot, simply Frank, because it gives me more exposure. And I need exposure because, unfortunately, you know, as I've always said, George, you know, and Frank, love makes the world go round, but money greases the wheel. I have a paid staff at my center. I have to pay them, and I don't ask the government to do that. I go to the corporate world.
Sponsorship.
And with an honor like this, people will take me even more serious. It's important to me because we do empower the lives of these young people, and so the Order of Canada means a lot. And for people to recognize
what you do is
quite gratifying. It really is. I mean, I've had people like the former chief of police, Fantino, and important people like Paul Godfrey, who have embraced me. And when I heard that was a decision, an unanimous decision, everybody on the committee voted for me, I thought, wow, there are a lot of other people's names that were renowned that never got it, and I did. It's an honor.
Well, I think they respected and acknowledged the sacrifices that you have made on behalf of people that needed you.